Okay, so moving on to assignment number two, assignment program number two. So we're going to start talking about some different precision levels with numeric data. So there's a couple of different types of floating point data we can do. Floating point meaning involving a decimal place. So no longer looking at integer numbers, but looking at real numbers instead. So something like 3.816 or something like that. So couple different data types we use here. The ones we're going to look at are the float, the double, and the decimal. So you can read through these. We'll check out the differences between these. So the program we're actually going to do is this one here. So we're going to set up three different variables. One is going to be type float, one is going to be type double, one is going to be type decimal, and then we're going to just going to output some values with those so you can see how those numbers get treated in the software to check out the various precision levels that you have there. So let's create a new program. This one's going to be called Real Numbers. Project. Real numbers. All right, so we got all that. Shrink that down. Okay, so we're going to have a float variable called f. A double called d. A decimal called M. So three different types of variables we're going to define here. And then we're going to do some different math with this. First one we're going to do, we're going to say f is equal to the reference here, what they're trying to do, f is equal to 0.1f. And when you put the f at the end of the end like this, what that is signifying is that this is going to be treated, that 0.1 is in floating point form, or is in float form. And I'm going to say console write line point one float is equal to space quotation mark, then I'm going to concatenate that with f, and what that should give us just run this. Whoops. So you can see how that just gives a 0.1 as our value. Okay, so 0.1 in float is that. So let's do the same thing with D equals 0.1, 0.1 in double is D. Let's add that in there too. Oops. Sorry, this should be 0.1. And you can see there this big long number, and this is the difference between using a float and a double. So a double gives you a whole lot more decimal places after the decimal. And then the next one going to be m is equal to 0.1 m. See that one now. All right, so that's a good example of that there. So let's copy all this stuff out. Let's go through another round of this. And this time we're going to use we're going to multiply them together. So F times F, M times M. run these. Now you can see even more difference there. And then we're going to divide. Put 1/2 divided by 3. Do these ones. This should give us 0.33. I think that's what we wanted. This will be the final one. And you can see how that breaks down. So the float gives us that many decimal places. I think that's 6 decimal places, 16 decimal places with the decimal, and then that many decimal places with the double. In most of our math, we're going to use double is what we're going to use for any type of floating point. So double will be the most common one that we use out of all of these. I'll put a couple commas in here. Those just to say that we have comments. Take my screen, screenshot it. I don't have all my program in there. I got to make sure I get all the program. If you can't fit all your program in one screenshot, you can do multiple screenshots to get it all. Word document. And there we go. So that is program number 2. Okay. So program number 2, kind of a weird one, but basically the main takeaway from that is showing the differences between the level of precision between a float, a decimal, and a double. Double will be the one we most commonly use going forward. Okay. So that is it for this one.